As you can see by the program, it's my turn next. The Gandhi Dancers is a new composition of a descriptive nature concerning the days of the building of the first railroads. The term Gandhi Dancer was a nickname given to the workers who laid the track from east to west. You'll hear some of the old railroad songs, Drilly Terrier's Drill, Take This Hammer, Wabash Cannonball, and we hope that you'll hear a few of the sounds of the old days of the railroad trains, the Gandhi Dancers. We are privileged to present another guest conductor this evening. Just a word about Colonel Howard, which you'll find more of in the program. As the founder and conductor and commander of the United States Air Force Band and Symphony Orchestra, Colonel Howard built a musical organization with an outstanding record of achievement. In an amazingly short period of time, its members were acclaimed America's international musical ambassadors. The organization and its commander won the hearts of more than 35 million music lovers throughout the world. As chief of bands and music, the Air Force, Colonel Howard controlled and guided the destinies of more than 2,000 assigned Air Force musicians and commissioned officers, set the standards for 78 Air Force bands. He established commissioned officer status for Air Force band directors, created and maintained the only music career progression within the military services. He attained the highest rank ever given to a music officer within the United States military forces. Since that time, he has continued his devotion to the bands of this country by being the chairman of the Sousa Memorial Committee, which raised $100,000 from individuals and bands, bandmasters, and the music industry to help build the John F. Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C., and to dedicate the John Philip Sousa Stage in the name of the March King. And any of you who contributed through your own bands or as individuals or through music industry firms will find the name of your organization on that plaque, which is set in place for all time at the Kennedy Center, the John Philip Sousa Stage. Colonel Howard will now conduct Henry Fillmore's famous march, Rolling Thunder. Colonel George Howard. To bring back Dr. Avelli, and we have a magnificent piece of music written by Dr. Al Reed, which will be sung by the Collegiate Singers with their preparation by their conductor and also the band with its preparation by their own conductor. Now, Dr. Avelli will do the number today, and Dr. Max Rafferty, whom you've already met, is going to do the narration. And for those of you to whom Dr. Rafferty may be new. I doubt if there are any here, but I just want to read one or two things from the program notes. Dr. Max Rafferty, a lifelong career teacher and school administrator, the most widely known figure in American education today. Since 1963, he has authored a nationally syndicated column appearing in more than 100 newspapers from coast to coast. He's a regular guest on national and regional television radio programs. 1963 to 71, he served as the twice-elected superintendent of public instruction for the state of California, with more schools and more students under his supervision than any other man in the country. And in 1971, he became dean of the School of Education at Tri-State University in Alabama, where we are very happy to say he now resides. For the Testament of an American, with a text by music publisher, the late Max Winkler, and music by Dr. Alfred Reed, now present the Collegiate Singers, Tri-State University Band, Dr. Max Rafferty, and Dr. William Ravelli.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin the final selection on this evening's program, I would be remiss if I did not extend and express my profound, deep, everlasting thanks to this wonderful band and to Dean Long and his associates for the privilege and opportunity to be here and work with these wonderful young Americans. They have been magnificent. Their attitude is so beautiful, like a real fine pro. They cooperated, they gave me everything I asked, and they did it in a beautiful, lovely manner. I want you to know I'm grateful. Thank you so much. I won't have the opportunity at the end of the concert to this fine choir and your director, my profound thanks also. You sing beautifully, and I know that it'll be a fine, sterling performance. Regarding the work, Testament of an American, Max Winkler was a Romanian Jew. He came to America with only a dollar or two in his pocket. He was an amateur violinist, played by ear, and he played in a ghetto band where the little band went into the apartments of New York, that is down below, not into them, but on the ground below, and played for the occupants of the apartments. And they would throw, these in the old days, they would throw down nickels, dimes, pennies, whatnot, for the money they were getting, or the music they were getting. One lady threw down a penny. It went into Max Winkler's hat band, an old, very old, dilapidated hat, with a loose band, and the penny went in there. Max Winkler took that penny, applied for a job at Carl Fisher's as a stock clerk. He had a marvelous memory and a keen curiosity. He learned the titles, the composers, the publishers of thousands of pieces. And this was in the days when there was no sound on the soundtrack of the movies. Orchestras played in the pits. Some of you young people wouldn't remember this, of course, would know about it. They played in the pit and cued to the music. Mr. Winkler developed the cue sheet, which would provide the musical titles and background for the movie. Mr. Winkler became a tremendously successful businessman, but he never lost his sense of humor, which was beautiful. He never lost his attitude of kindness toward his colleagues and his fellow man. He was truly one of the greatest Americans I've ever known. And when you hear the text, you will agree that he was truly a fine American. He asked that this eulogy be expressed at his death. He asked that the Star Spangled Banner be played at his funeral, and it was. He was truly a great American. He gave tons of music away to people who couldn't afford to buy it. One day, one of the conductors to whom he gave so much music, he asked, "Max, how can you pay your rent when you give so much music away. Max says, I own the building. So he was truly a great American, and we're privileged to play it for you, the Testament of America. Thank you.
I stand with my right hand over my heart, looking up to heaven with tears in my eyes, and thanking God for the privilege of fashioning a prayer of my own in honor of this land, a land consisting of 50 kingdoms, each bigger, better, greater, richer, and freer than any kingdom or piece of land on the face of this earth, a land that has given me freedom and protection, as well as spiritual and material riches, with countless opportunities to share all with the more unfortunate and with my family and friends. A land I should be sorry to leave, because it is a sequel to God's paradise. And it would be a sad moment indeed for anyone not to be able to hear the golden tones and the silver words of the great song that is America. I have stood on the good earth of my beloved country for many, many years, and this same good earth will one day be with me forever and ever. I thank God for this privilege denied to so many in offering this prayer as a testament for all America.
Here I stand, upon my good earth, upon thee. Wonder and why, or it never should be. Elsa's procession to the cathedral from the opera Lohengrin by Richard Wagner, with its medieval color and pageantry, prefaces Elsa's betrothal to Lohengrin, the mystic knight of the Holy Grail who has come to deliver the people of Brabant, or Antwerp, from the Hungarian invaders. In the operatic presentation, a large double chorus representing the people of Antwerp adds its song of solemn praise to that of the orchestra. It is in this music, mystic yet powerful, that we find Wagner striking out with those new and intense musical thoughts which were to culminate in Tristan, The Ring, and Parsifal. Not quite emancipated from the musical speech of his operatic contemporaries, one finds in the Lohengrin score those unmistakable flights into musico-dramatic magnificent, transcending all that preceded it in idiom and musical adventure. At this time, Dr. Long conducts Elsa's procession to the cathedral from Lohengrin by Richard Wagner.